be explaining you about the fabrication process. So basically in this fabrication process we will be knowing how a particular transistor will be fabricated. That means it will be having some sequence of steps. Okay, so actually before entering into this fabrication process, first you have to know a rough idea how this particular whatever this IC or the transistor will be there, how it is going to form. Okay, so actually the step from where we are going to start means what is the basic step means here we will be starting from the sand. Okay, so because why we are opting for the sand means from the sand only we will be getting the silicon, right? So we will be the availability of the silicon will be much. That means we are going to obtain the silicon from the sand only. Okay, so from this sand we will be getting the silicon. Okay, so if we are going to get the silicon from this sand, but it will be a impure. Okay, so in order to form the silicon pure, we will be following the refining process. Okay, so we have to refine this. So in this, after refining, we will be getting a 99.9% pure silicon, right? So here, whatever this 99.9% pure silicon we have got, that we will be inserting. Okay, so this pure silicon we will be inserting into a silicon bar. Let us consider this is a silicon bar. Okay, so I am just inserting this pure silicon, that is 99.9% pure silicon, into this silicon bar. Okay, so after inserting the silicon bar in this silicon into the silicon bar, then we will be heating this silicon bar in a RF heater. Okay, so this is the RF heater, and how we are going to heat means this will be in the molten stage. Okay, so this will be in the molten stage. Now we are going to heat that. Okay, so after heating, so we will be obtaining the silicon. That means here the silicon will be in the wet. Okay, so wet, and that means what we can tell is if we pour some water into the sand, we will be getting the thick mud, right? So in that way we will be obtaining the silicon from the silicon bar. That we will be calling it as the silicon ingot. Okay, so for this, and then after obtaining this, we will be having, that means it will be not having some, it should have some diameter, some dimension should be there, right? So that is the reason for the silicon ingot we will be doing the crystallization process. Okay, crystallization process. So after doing this, we will be getting a particular silicon wafer. Okay, so that means the silicon wafer will be having some diameter, some thickness, some size it will be having. Okay, so here after this crystallization process only, the particular silicon wafer, here our actual wafer will be formed. Okay, so in this silicon we'll be having, it will be having some thickness, right? So we are going to divide that into a number of silicon wafers. In this only we'll be making some divisions. Okay, so each and every single, that means the particular will be taking a separately, the single silicon wafer will be taken, and it will be having a some thickness, whatever the required thickness is there, that will be there, and the diameter will be there, all this will be there for this. Okay, so in this silicon wafer only, then whatever these ICs are there, it will be having some n number of ICs we will be fabricating. Okay, so I am taking an individual IC here. Okay, so in this individual IC, again you know the IC will be consisting of active and the passive elements like resistors, capacitors and the transistors. Okay, right, so it will be having the active and the passive elements. Okay, so I am taking a single transistor again. Okay, so let us consider this is a BJT transistor. Okay, so basically it will be starting from the sand, we will be obtaining the silicon, and finally we will be getting our silicon wafer. Okay, so for coming to this fabrication process, directly we will be starting our step from this silicon wafer only. Okay, so first you have to know how our silicon wafer is formed. Okay, so from this silicon, right? So now I will explain you about one of the transistor fabrication process, right? So for this fabrication process, it will be having some, all the, as I have said, it will be having some steps. Okay, so starting from the silicon wafer, and how we are going to give the connections between the terminals, right? So now let's start with the NMOS fabrication process, right? So you can fabricate any MOS, any transistors like NMOS, PMOS, CMOS, BiCMOS. Okay, you can fabricate. For all this, you will be having the same step. what we are going to do means wafer production. Wafer production. So here what is our wafer we are going to get? Silicon wafer. So how we are going to get the silicon wafer? You know that. Starting from the sand, we are going to get the silicon. We are going to do the refining process. Then we will be getting 99.9% pure silicon. And I mean so that I am pouring that silicon into the silicon bath. And then we will be heating at the RF heater at some temperature. And then we will be getting the silicon in what? And from that we are going to get divide that. Okay. So from there we will be getting a silicon wafer, right? So this is the wafer production, and which will be having the particular diameter and the thickness. Okay. So this is our silicon wafer which I am taking, right? So now I want to fabricate the NMOS transistor, right? So if I want to fabricate the NMOS transistor, means the type of substrate which we are going to consider, that should be of opposite. That is the P-type substrate I am considering. P substrate. This is our silicon wafer. Okay. So this method we will be calling it as the wafer production. How we are going to get that? Okay. So this is our first step, that is the wafer production. Okay. So this is the P substrate, right? So the first one is completed. And next one is what? Epitaxial growth. What is this epitaxial growth means? On the silicon wafer, I am just patterning a thin layer of SiO2. Okay. So this is again a P substrate. I am just patterning a thin layer of this SiO2. See here. Okay. So this size, this thickness will be 1 micrometer thickness. Okay. So why we are going to pattern this 1 micrometer SiO2 means in order to protect this silicon wafer. Okay. So we will be having some further steps. Okay. So for that is the reason we have to make this, right? So that is survive this. So that is the reason we are going to pattern this SiO2. Okay. So after that, next one is what? The photoresist layer and the masking will be coming. Okay. So again, I am taking a silicon wafer P substrate. Here you will be having a SiO2, and then I am adding a photoresist layer here. See, this is the photoresist layer. Okay. So the reason for adding this means in order to acquire the required thickness. Okay. So it will be having some amount of thickness. Okay. So in order to acquire that, the photoresist layer will be masked here. Huh? So this is what we are going to call it as the photolithography. Okay. Photolithography. Okay. And then the fourth step is what? We have to do the masking process here. Masking. Okay. So why we are going to do, how we are going to do this masking means, first I am taking this silicon wafer, right? So P substrate, and then the SiO2, you know this, and then we will be having the photoresist layer, right? So here how the masking process will be taking means, we will be exposing this entire silicon wafer to a UV light. Okay, it will be exposed to that, right? So now then we have to form the gate, drain and source terminals, right? So that is the reason in this area I am doing the masking procedure. See, because the gate terminal should be produced here. That means why we are going to use this masking means, in order to make this particular area more polymerized, that means the hardened process, that means it will be able to stand up to the external conditions, okay, like humidity, whatever it is going to get, temperature, it has to withstand to all that external condition. That is the reason we are going to do the masking procedure here, okay. So after doing this masking procedure, what we are going to get, this means here again the silicon wafer and the P substrate we are having, and now here what we are going to get, that means whatever this extra SiO2 and photoresist layers are there, that we are going to etch out. That is called as the etching process. How we are going to remove that means, with the help of some chemicals like H2SO4 and HCl. Okay. So by making use of this HCl and H2SO4, I am removing these two parts. Okay. So by removing like that, what it is going to happen means, our particular gate terminal will be formed here. Okay, the unwanted portion of this SiO2 and photoresist layer will be removing, etching out with this help of two chemicals. Here at this location only the gate terminal will be formed. Okay, so how we are going to form that gate terminal means, with the help of this, that means by fabricating the polysilicon. Okay, so see, this is the silicon region again, and polysilicon. By fabricating the polysilicon only, our gate terminal will be formed. Okay. So the one terminal is formed, gate terminal, and next the source and drain terminals are left, right? So again, what we have to do? Again, we'll be doing this masking only, because the next two terminals should also be hardened, right? So that is the reason I'm taking here. This is the silicon wafer, and again the B substrate. Okay. See here, it will be like this, and okay, and our gate terminal is formed here. You know that. Okay. This is our gate terminal, and then the gate drain and source terminal should also be formed, right? So again, I'm doing the UV masking, UV light, and exposing this. Here I'm doing the masking procedure here and here in these regions, because here the drain and source terminal should be formed, right? So again, these two terminals should also be withstand to the external condition. So that is the reason we are doing the masking. Okay. So and again, here we'll be doing the diffusion process. By the way, what is the diffusion? It's nothing but introducing the type of impurities. Either it is a n-type impurities or the p-type impurities. Okay, right? So here, as I'm considering, we have to fabricate the NMOS transistor. Okay, so that means what? Here we have to introduce the n-type impurities, right? So by introducing this n-type impurities only, whatever our drain and the source terminals are there, those will be formed. How we are going to form this? First, I'm going to heat this wafer at the high temperature. Okay, so first we have to heat this wafer at the high temperature. Then we have to pass a gas. Okay, so in that gas we'll be having this particular n-type impurities. Okay, so by passing there, we'll be forming the particular drain and source terminals will be formed. This process we'll be calling it as the diffusion process, right? So now our transistor will be looking like this. This is the P substrate, and as you know this, okay. So here our polysilicon, this is the gate terminal, and here we will be getting the drain and the source terminals. Okay, so this is the n-type, right? So it will be like this. N-type impurities, right? So this is the source terminal and this is the drain terminal. They have been formed. Okay, all the three terminals have been formed. See, as you can see, this is a NMOS transistor which I have considered. This is the gate, this is the drain, and this is the source. Okay, so actual our transistor has been formed, but we have to give the connections, right? See, this is connected to the VDD and this is connected to the VSS, let us say ground. Okay, so in order to give these connections, we have to use the metallization process. Okay, so for using the process metallization, what we are going to use here means aluminium as the metal, because it is a very good conductor, and at the same time, for that reason, we will be using this aluminium for the proper connections between these all the terminals. Okay, so here we have to give the connections between this VDD and the drain terminal, and then VSS and the source terminal. Okay, so that is the reason we will be using here aluminium metal, right? So now this is the silicon wafer which I am considering. Okay, so this is the P substrate, right? Okay, our gate terminal has been formed here. How we are going to form this gate terminal? With the help of the polysilicon. Okay. Excuse me, right? And then our drain and source terminals have also been formed here. Drain and source, right? So as we are using this, how we are going to form this drain and source terminals? By introducing the n-type impurities, and that is at the end, that is the diffusion process, right? So in this way, our drain and source terminals have been formed. Okay, so this is the drain and this is the source, right? So now we have to give the connections. Before that, we'll be having some oxide layer, because we have to give the connections like this. Okay, so this is the oxide layer. This is the entire oxide layer only. Now for this, we have to give the connections like this. Metal. This is the representation of the aluminium metal. Okay, so here also it will be like this, and here. Okay, so this is our final transistor, that is the fabricated. combination of this NMOS transistor will be looking. See, as you can see here, this is the gate, drain and source terminal, and this is gate, drain and source terminal. If you do, if you invert like this, you can be able to see that. Okay, so this is how the steps which are involved in this fabrication process and how we are going to do the fabrication process. First, we have to know how the silicon wafer is produced, and then the fabrication process will be followed by that. Okay, thank you.